this morning is Tim Oldham from AdAlta. Tim, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good to see you, Tim. A little while since you and I last spoke, so perhaps give us a refresh here, Tim, on AdAlta and your iBody technology.
Yeah, Andrew, AdAlta is a drug discovery company based in Melbourne, founded in 2007, listed in 2016. And we're built around this really powerful drug discovery platform, which we call iBodies. Essentially, they are an antibody-like protein that mimics the structure and features of antibodies found in the shark immune system. And this gives us the ability to hit drug targets that traditional antibodies have been unable to address successfully.
What conditions are you looking to treat here?
So there's a wide range of applications for iBodies potentially, but our portfolio today is built around two therapeutic areas. The first is in fibrosis and inflammation, and that's where our internal wholly owned programs sit. And the second is in immuno-oncology, which is where our external collaborations are working today.
Well, give us a snapshot, Tim, as far as development within the portfolio and these programs.
Yeah, so our lead program is called AD214. This is wholly owned by AdAlta. It is a novel product for fibrosis or fibrotic diseases. So this is scarring of internal organs. The lead indication is a disease called idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, which is a bit of a mouthful, but essentially that means scarring of your lungs. And you can imagine as your lungs scar and stiffen, it becomes much harder to breathe. We don't know what causes it. It's a rare disease, but patients die after about 4 years from diagnosis on average. And today there is no cure. There are two drugs on the market that slow progression, but they have some pretty nasty side effects that many people can't tolerate. And unfortunately, with the advent of COVID, the likely incidence of idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis is likely to increase. So we have a new drug that has just got through phase one clinical trials for this disease. It's been very well tolerated, and now we're moving it towards phase two, pursuing both an inhaled and an intravenous formulation. And then we've just added a second program in that same disease area into discovery in our laboratories in Melbourne. Yep. That's the internal program. And then the immuno-oncology space, we've got two really exciting collaborations going on there. The first is with GE Healthcare. And this is a preclinical stage program where we're designing iBodies that target an enzyme called granzyme B, which is produced when your immune system attacks cancer. Now, the new immuno-oncology drugs, the so-called checkpoint inhibitors, have revolutionized the way we treat cancer, but only for the 20 to 40% of people who respond. And today we don't know who they are until their tumor has progressed, which is kind of too late. So what we're trying to do with the granzyme B program is put a radio-labeled PET tracer onto the iBody that targets granzyme B so we can visualize the patients that are responding. And that's a co-development with GE Healthcare that's generating revenue for us already and is likely to get to commercial sales much faster than a therapeutic development. And then the final program we have is a really exciting collaboration with Karina Biotech, where we're putting iBodies onto CAR T cells. This is one of the hottest fields of immuno-oncology today. It's likely to be about a $20 billion market by the end of the decade. And we're solving the challenges of making iBodies available for solid tumors using Karina's excellent CAR T technology and our iBodies to provide the targeting.
Tim, just back to AD214 for a moment. Are you seeking partners on this drug?
So we will be relatively soon. We want to take a few more steps towards the optimal formulation for phase two over the next 3 to 6 months maximum. And that's when we think that the value will start to be really unlocked for that particular asset. We know new products in the IPF space are routinely licensed from phase one onwards, and the upfronts can be as high as 45 million euros. So there's a very, very, very attractive asset class. And just to put that in context, our current market cap is about $20 to $25 million. So that sort of milestone up front is more than our current market cap today, which we think is a good indicator of why AdAlta is a pretty exciting investment for people to look at.
Good to see you this morning. Tim, thanks for your time.
Thanks, Andrew.